Hello, ladies and gentlemen, it's Mike here at Game From Scratch, and once again, Visual Studio Code just got an upgrade. So this is Visual Studio Code June 2024 release, or version 1.91 if you prefer. To be honest, it's not the biggest release ever, but there's a couple of nice new features in here. I'm going to showcase two of them, and then we'll come back to the release notes and look at some of the stuff that is there. But the big new things, in my humble opinion, are these two. So first off, notice when I come down here to Settings, the lack of profile. So what they've done is they've consolidated all of the profile stuff into one place. To do so, what you do is you go into Preferences, Settings, and you look for this one, Workbench, Experimental, Enable New Profiles UI. Turn that one on, and you are good to go. So now what you'll find, you come down to your settings, you now have this profile setting right here. What this is a standardized user interface for handling profiles. So if you want to set up and create profiles, manage profiles, delete profiles, etc., they are all implemented here. You can configure what is in a profile and so on and so forth. Very much nice to have all of that stuff consolidated into a single place. So if you're using profiles, you will like this release because everything has been put together into this new single UI. Again, all available here, but you do need to enable it. So this to get this one here, once again, you come on in here and you set this experimental enable new profiles UI. Once that's gone, the profile is gone. Now, one thing that isn't gone though, is if you are using profiles, you will now find a new menu over here and you can create a new instance of Visual Studio Code using your profile. Just boom. And done. So even if you don't have the new functionality turned on, that feature is available. So if you're working with profiles, definitely a nice upgrade in that regard. The other thing that I love, and this is one of those things I kind of wish was there since the very, very, very beginning, is extensions. So let's say I came in here, I want to install an extension. So let's say I want to do the Godot extension. So I'm going to come in here, pick Godot, and we'll grab it right here. So what you can now do is this. Install another version. And you can actually pick an old version, so no longer having to install and downgrade or anything like that. If you want to install an extension, but you don't want to install the newest extension, you now have that opportunity available to you. By the way, if you sync your account settings, you also have the option now of not syncing an extension across your account syncing. So some definite nice new features in that regard. Those are the two new biggest highlight features in my humble opinion. Now, if you're a Python developer, you may actually have a different opinion there because there's some decent Python love here. Also, some stuff around accessibility. So they've got the accessible view for editor hover. So you can see, again, nice zoom in on what you're looking at there. So if you want to turn this one on, an option is available. They also have easier to distinguish links from regular text by turning on accessibility underline links. And you can see what they look like over there. On top of that, there's now a thread settings for maximum threads for search if you want to control that. Again, the new profiles editor that we saw there, we saw that in action earlier on. And again, that new menu item for creating using your selected profile. And again, the extensions changes. These are the big ones in my humble opinion. So you can now install without syncing and you can install a very specific version, which is very, very nice. Another neat thing you can do now is unset a theme color. So if a theme sets a color on a border that you don't like, you can now actually remove it. So if you're using a theme, but there's one thing you don't like about it, you can actually remove or override that particular color change. There's another option here, which is actually kind of neat. You can learn more about it here in the code actions on save here, but you can now configure an action to occur when you save a file, which is kind of nice. Then we go into source control. I don't use a lot of source control myself, so this isn't tangible to me, but they have a new visualization option available. It's the SCM experimental show history graph. And you can see this new history graph is available, showing you the synchronization changes that have happened with your code. Love it or hate it, this again is experimental and they're looking for feedback on it. So if you like this, do let them know. If you hate this, well, do let them know. But there is this new feedback graph for changes there. Let me know what you think of this one in the comments down below. We got some improvements to notebooks, including the ability to find in-text selections, as well as to copy or open text output with the context menu. Then we've got terminal, the ability to copy or paste escape sequence OSC 52. So it's now supported. Primary use case is clipboard access for TMUX. New custom glyphs. Then a JavaScript debugger now shows correct value of shadowed variables. TypeScript 5.5 is now supported. And then come on down here. This is one of those things I like. They're finally talking about Copilot like it's an extension as opposed to like it's a feature of Visual Studio Code. It's something I've been harping on in the last couple of releases. Maybe they're actually listening. So they're talking about changes to GitHub Copilot as an extension. Bravo team, keep that up. So here, compact inline chat, terminal initial hint. So a new hint is displayed on the terminal to help discover the inline chat. And apply an editor command on a code block in the chat view uses the language model to determine the best approach for applying the changes to the current editor. So some improvements to Copilot support. Again, I'm happy to see they're talking about it as a plugin as opposed to as just new features in Visual Studio Code. That's one of those things that has been irking me lately. If you work with Python, we have the new Python environment discovery using the Python environment tools, which weirdly enough are written in Rust. This has got the capability of basically finding Python installs, virtual environments, etc. So again, written in Rust to ensure rapid. So we have a TypeScript written language hosted in JavaScript running Rust to find Python. We live in a weird world. So if you're looking, if you want to hook up your Python environment, should be easier now with the new Python environment tools. And then in terms of Smart Send in REPL, so now enabled Smart Send in the Visual Studio Code native REPL. So this is like if you're doing direct feedback with your Python code, basically runtime evaluation stuff. When you place your cursor on a line of Python code and press to Shift Enter, the Python extension would send the exact line contents to the native REPL, even if it would fail, for example, because it's part of a multi-line command. Shift Enter sends the minimum executable code in a non-nested scenario or a highest top-level code in a nested scenario, enables user to quickly Shift Enter through their files to run the maximum amount of executable code with the least amount of effort. So that's kind of nice there. And then we've got some improvements to the way extensions are authored, some proposed APIs, and that's about it. So that, ladies and gentlemen, is this month's release. Again, not a huge amount. I do like, again, that they're talking about Copilot finally as a separate thing and not as a feature, even though in the summary they sure don't. On top of that, again, the biggest things for me, I do like the extensions, the ability to install a specific version of them, and I like the new profile editor. I don't work with Python, so the new Python stuff isn't really for me, but it might be for you, might be a nice big deal there. And then on top of that, just sort of refinements and improvements. Nothing really magical in this release, but let me know what you think. Comments down below. Talk to you all later. Goodbye.